Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back to my channel. And if you are new here, welcome to my channel, where you can learn the real world coding experience. And this is Huang, the coding expert. If you watch all my videos about how to pass the CBC exam or any outpatient coding exam, you should know my tips and strategy by now. Each coding instructor may offer a different way of how to pass the exam, so you may have to choose whichever technique that works for you. My approach will help you slowly to build up your confidence in tackling more complex cases in the near future. Today's topic is how to pass the CBC exam guarantee in 2020, part 4, the urinary system. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the notification button below so that you wouldn't miss anything. Alright, without further ado, let's get right into it. Before that, I just want to go over the CBC exam question in order to track our progress up to this point. So far, I have covered the integumentary system, 10,000 series CBT, the dissective system, 40,000 series CBT, the medical terminology, the anatomy, the IC10CM, the coding guidelines. And last week, I covered the musculoskeletal system, 20,000 series. Today, I will cover the urinary system, 50,000 series CBT. Once in a while, I recommend that you should check back this slide to see how far did you go and play catch up if you miss any lesson. As usual, what you need for my lessons are an IC10CM book, a CBT manual book, notepad, highlighters, pen and pencils, drinking water, coffee or cream tea, a quiet place that you can study. You can also use some calming music in the background to help you relax and focus. I'll leave the link of a new relaxing music channel that my student had just created, which I really enjoy listening to it. And last but not least is your positive mental attitude, which is the most important. And that will help you to do well. Before that, I would like to go over the basic anatomy and physiology of the urinary system. The urinary system consists of two kidneys, two ureters, one urinary bladder, and one urethra. Each kidney is divided into the cortex, the medulla. Inside the cortex of both kidneys are thousands of microscopic filtering units called nephrons. So it's important to drink lots of water in order for the kidneys and the urinary system to function properly. Here are the basic functions of the kidneys that you need to know for the exam. The kidneys perform many crucial functions, including filter the blood, remove waste and produce urine, maintain the homeostasis, regulate the blood volumes and electrolytes, produce a hormone called EBO, erythropoietin. EBO causes the bone marrow to make red blood cells, which then carry oxygen throughout the body. When the kidneys are damaged, they do not make enough EBO. As a result, the bone marrow makes fewer red blood cells, causing anemia. Here are some common diseases and disorders of the urinary system that usually require some kinds of intervention. Benign prostatic hyperplasia, BPH, also called prostate gland enlargement, which could block the flow of urine out of the bladder. It's a very common condition as men get older. Prostate cancer. Urolithiasis means calculus or stone that form in the urinary tract. Bladder tumors. Urinary tract strictures. Urinary incontinence is the loss of bladder control. In other words, inability to hold urine in the bladder. Interstitial cystitis is a chronic condition causing bladder pressure, bladder pain, and sometimes pelvic pain. Urinary tract endoscopy. If you watch my lesson about how to call GI endoscopy, you should recognize this device. Basically, endoscopic device consists of flexible tubing that contain a series of light mirror lens and optic fibers. The inducements transmit light around corners, twisted, bends, allow direct visualization of body system not easily visualized by other means. So, what is a cystoscopy or cystourethroscopy? A cystoscopy is an examination of the urine of the bladder and urethra. The doctor performing the examination uses a cystoscope, a long thin inducement with a tiny lens and the line on the end that is inserted into the bladder. The doctor inserts the cystoscope into the patient's urethra. And the small lens magnifies the inner lining of the urethra and the bladder, allowing the doctor to see inside the hollow bladder. Similarly, a ureteroscopy is an examination of procedure using a ureteroscope. A ureteroscope is longer and thinner than a cystoscope and is used to see beyond the bladder into the ureters, the tubes that carry urine from the kidney to the bladder. Through the ureteroscope, the doctor can see a stone in the ureter and then remove it with a small basket at the end of a wire. Another way to trick a stone to a ureteroscope is to extend a flexible fiber to a scope up to the stone and then, with the laser beam shone to the fiber, break the stone into the smaller pieces that can pass out of the body in the urine. Alright, I'm ready to tackle the first case. Are you? Let's do it. Case number one. Follow my tip and strategy. A and C have the same code. 25000. So they are in the same group. B and D have different codes. 52310 and 52332. So they are in different groups. This step at least will tell you how many codes that you need to look it up in your CPT books. There are three codes in this case, 52000, 52310, and 52332. Please pause the video and look them up now. I wait for you. Assuming that you already look it up in your CBT book and hear what you find. 52000, cystourethroscopy, separate procedure. Please highlight the main term that describes the procedure. Here's the tip for today. If a CPT code descriptor includes the term separate procedure in parentheses, it means that the CPT code may not be reported separately with a related procedure. It's bundled into the main procedure on the same body part or organ. You can only assign this code when this is the only procedure performed, or it is carried out independently or unrelated to the main procedure. This may represent a different section, different site or organ system, different approach, so please keep this in mind. I say it again. It means that the CPT code may not be reported separately with a related procedure. It's bundled into the main procedure on the same body part or organ. You can only assign this code when this is the only procedure performed, or it is carried out independently or unrelated to the main procedure. This may represent a different section, different site or organ system, different approach, so please keep this in mind. 52310, cystourethroscopy with removal of foreign body, calculus, or ureteral stains. Follow my tip and strategy. Please highlight the main terms that uniquely describe the surgery or procedure. 52332, cystourethroscopy with insertion of indwelling ureteral stain. Also, I highlight the main term or the keyword for this code. After you are done highlighting the main terms in order to identify the key difference between each code, now is the time for you to read the procedure report. A physician performed a cystoscopy with ureteral stain removal. What is the correct code for this service? Alright, you already highlighted the difference between each subclinical and also highlighted the key element in the procedure report. I give you a few seconds to tell me which subclinical correctly describes the procedure, and that will be the right answer. If you pick CPT 52310, cystourethroscopy with removal of foreign body, calculus, or ureteral stain, congratulations. This is the right code for this procedure. 52000 should not be reported separately, as I already explained. You can only use this code when this is the only procedure performed. Otherwise, it considered bundled into the main procedure, which the removal of the stain endoscopically. That said, the correct answer is B, 52310. Alright, let's move on to the next case. Follow my tips and strategy. B and C have the same code, 5179A, so they are in the same group. B and D have different codes, 51736 and 51792, so they are in different groups. This step will let you know that there are three codes, 51736, 51798, and 51792, that you need to look up in your CPT book. Please pause the video and look them up now. I wait for you. I really mean it. You need to physically touch your CPT book, open it, and look it up, then highlight the main term for each and every single code that you are working on, so that when you are in this testing room, if you come across to any of these codes, you will see what you already highlight, and that will save you lots of time. Believe me, I'm not only the coding expert, but also the coding exam prep expert. Practice makes perfect. Assuming that you already look it up in your CPT book and hear what you find. 51736, symbol uroflowmetry, UFR. For example, stopwatch flow rate, mechanical uroflowmeter. Please highlight the main term that describes this code. 51798, measurement of post-voiding residual time and all bladder capacity by ultrasound non-imaging. I also highlight the main terms or keyword for this code. 51792, stimulus evoke response, measurement of bubble cavernosa reflex latency times. The main term is also highlighted. After you are done highlighting the main term, you should know the key difference between each CPT code. Now is the time for you to read the procedure report. An 80-year-old male patient in a rehab hospital started post-hip transplant. He had been trouble voiding. After his last voiding, the physician measured his bladder capacity using a non-imaging ultrasound device. How should you code for this procedure? Alright, you already highlighted the difference between each subclinical and also highlighted the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you 15 seconds to tell me which code is correctly describing this procedure. Your time starts now. If you pick 51798, measurement of post-voiding residual time and not bladder capacity by ultrasound not imaging, it's great. But we are not done yet. We only have to wait there. We can eliminate A and D. B and C still remain. Now, The only difference between B and C is a modified 50 for bilateral procedure. If you remember the anatomy of the urinary system that I just go over from the previous slide. The urinary system consists of two kidneys, two ureters, but only one urinary bladder. So modified 50 for bilateral or pair organs is not appropriate to use for the bladder. Having said that, the correct answer is B, 51798A. If you enjoy what you have learned so far, then please pause the video and click the like and share button so that this video will expose to more students who want to learn but could not afford to pay for a formal class. That'd be great. Let's tackle the next case. Case number 3. Follow my tips and strategy. Take a look at the first code of the answer and separate them in groups. A and B have the same code, 52000, so they are in the same group. C and D have the same code, 52010, so they are also in the same group. Now you know there are two codes that you have to look it up in your CBT book. CBT 52000 and CBT 52010. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming that you already look it up in your CBT book and hear what you find. 52000 systole ureteroscopy separate procedure. Again, this is another CBT code that its descriptor includes the term separate procedure in parentheses. It means that this CBT code may not be reported separately with a related procedure. It's bundled into the main procedure on the same body part or organ. You can only assign this code when this is the only procedure performed or is carried out independently or unrelated to the main procedure. This may represent a different session, different site or organ system, different approach. Don't ever forget this. You need to know this not only for the coding exam, but also for everyday real-world coding. 52010, systole ureteroscopy with ejaculation duct catheterization with the wood duct irrigation installation or duct radiography, exclusive of radiologic service. Follow my tip and strategy. I highlight the main term and keyword that distinctively describe this procedure code. After you're done highlighting the main terms and identifying the key difference between each code, now is the time for you to read the procedure report. A physician performed a systole ureteroscopy with an ejaculatory duct catheterization and irrigation. Duct radiography was also performed to visualize ejaculatory duct system. What CPT codes should be reported? Alright, you already highlight difference between each CPT code and also highlight the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you a few seconds to tell me which CPT code would be the right code for this procedure. If you pick CBT 52010, systole ureteroscopy with ejaculation duct catheterization with or without irrigation, installation or duct radiography, exclusive of radiologic service, you are correct. This code description matches what you highlight in the procedure report. You can eliminate A and B from here. C and D still remain. And the only difference between these two codes is 74440. Any CB code that starts with 70,000 series is the imaging code. Now, I want you to pause the video, open your CBT book and find the note under this code 52010 and tell me what you see. Is it what you see? For radiological supervision and interpretation, use 77440. Now you see, the note under this code actually guides you to the correct answer that you have to report, 7440 for the doc radiography, which is also performed in this case. That said, the correct answer is C, 52010-7440. How are you doing so far? Let's bring it on. Case number 4. This case is very straightforward. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 50060, 50075, 50561, and 50580. So all you have to do now is open your CPT book and look them up to find out what they are. Please pause the video and do it now. I wait for you. Assuming that you already look it up in your CPT book and hear what you got. 50060, nephrolithotomy, removal of calculus. I highlight the main term that describes the procedure. 50075, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the codal ball, 50060, which is the parent code, except it is for a removal of the last Staghorn calculus. 50561, it's also an identical, so I have to show the parent code, 50551. Basically, 50561 includes all the information from the parent code, which is renal endoscopy through established nephrostomy with or without irrigation. And it also includes the removal of foreign body or calculus. 50580 is also on identical, so I have to show the parent code, 50570. So basically, 50580 includes all information from the parent code, which is renal endoscopy to nephrostomy with or without irrigation. And it also includes the removal of foreign body or calculus. After you're done highlighting the main terms, you would know the key difference between each CPT code. Now is the time for you to read the procedure report. A physician endoscopically removed a 0.3 cm calculus from patient's right kidney under general anesthesia. Access was given to an established nephrostomy. What is the correct code for this procedure? Alright, you already highlight the difference between each CPT code and also highlight the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you 15 seconds to tell me which CPT code would be the correct code for this procedure. Your time starts now. If you pick 50561, renal endoscopy to establish nephrostomy with removal of foreign body or calculus, you're correct. Congratulations, you are on fire. If you really pay close attention to the keyword that you highlight, you will recognize the difference between 50551 and 50570 is the term to establish nephrostomy, which is the artificial opening. And nephrostomy means cutting or making an incision in the kidney. The procedure report document to an established nephrostomy. So the correct answer is C, 50561, removal of foreign body or calculus to an established nephrostomy. I hope you follow me okay. All right. I friendly reminder that if you forgot to click the like, share, or subscribe button, now is the time to do so before I tackle the last case. Follow my tips and strategy. A, B, and D have the same code, 55700, so they are in the same group. C has a different code, 55705, so it is in a separate group. Now you know there are two codes that you have to look it up in your CPT book, CPT 55700 and 55705. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming that you already look it up in your CBT book and hear what you find. 55700, biopsy, prostate, needle or punch, single or multiple, any approach. I highlight the main terms and keyword that describe the surgery or procedure. 55705, this is an identical, so it includes all information from the pinnacle 55700, except it's not done by a needle, but by an incision. Now you know the key difference between these two codes, so it is the time for you to read the procedure report. A 50-year-old male presented today to the urology outpatient clinic with an elevated PSA of 6.1. Prostate on exam, however, appears normal. The risk and benefit of a biopsy are discussed with the patient and his spouse who has accompanied him. The patient is placed in the left lateral position. The ultrasound probe was introduced. Prostate volume is determined to normal. However, some calcifications are observed. There does not appear to be any abnormalities. The base of the prostate is infiltrated with 1% xylocaine. Random biopsies are performed with a needle in the usual fashion. Patient tolerated the procedure well. Result of the biopsy were back quickly and demonstrated malignant prostate cancer. Alright, you already highlight the key difference between each CBT code and also highlight the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you 15 seconds to tell me which CBT code would be the correct code for this procedure. Your time starts now. If you pick 55700, biopsy, prostate, needle or punch, single or multiple, any approach, this is great, congratulations. Based on the procedure report, the biopsy are performed with a needle. So 55700 is the correct code. From here, you can only eliminate C. So A, B and D still remain. Look at the second set of code. 76872, and they all have this code. So we cannot use this code to single out the right answer. Let's move on to the next set of code. What is the ICD-10 diagnosis code? Open the ICD-10 CM book and look up this code I97.20, D29.1, and C61 and find out what they are. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming that you already look it up in your ICD-10 CM book and hear what you find. I97.20, elevated prostate specimen antigen PSA. D29.1, benign neoplasm of prostate. And C61, malignant neoplasm of prostate. Based on the result of the biopsy report, it demonstrates a malignant prostate cancer, so C61 is the right code. It's the first code listed and a principal diagnosis. That said, the correct answer is D, 55700, 76872, and C61. I hope that you are getting better and better and sharper each time you watch and learn from my video. And all I ask is your liking and sharing my videos to show your support to my channel. That is all for today. Thank you so much for watching, for liking and sharing. If you find this video helpful, informative and easy to learn with this format, or if you have any suggestion, then please leave me a comment below just to let me know. I really appreciate it. Until next time, have a great day.